So my name is Derek Theophil, and I'll be speaking a little bit about the geospatial information management in Dominica. Well, historically, a lot of work has been done through the British and also through the Land and Service Department, trying to look more mainly at terrestrial, as you can see here, features over the years. And then the Physical Planning Department got in the game, starting to digitize actually some of that information and creating databases and so forth, so that the information can be used or spread and so forth. So along the line, Land and Surveys worked with Lime, which is one of the telecommunications companies, to build GIS capability, and they migrated to ArcView Ship first. I think at that point they were using ArcView 3.1. And in 95 they collaborated with the Physical Land and Surveys on that. In 2001, this was the first time that actually the marine space actually got any limelight with regards to mapping and geospatial to any significant degree. And that's when the Fisheries Division was introduced to the Coastal Resource Inventory System under the OECS NRMU. And that's actually when I learned GIS myself. Alan Mills, the guy from University of Greenwich, came there. I think also St. Vincent and BVI also were part of this program at that time. And we got computers, GIS software, and so forth, and lots of training in terms of developing GIS. And what another major aspect of that program was that a lot of GIS data was actually collated from a lot of other departments and institutions on the island and actually stored at the Fisheries Division at that time. Unfortunately, the thing is, I was the only person who was formally trained in GIS at that time. And my other activities included extension, monitoring, blah, 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 many hats. So that could not be possible to maintain over these years. But since then, the GIS has computers crashed, died, everything finished, and we don't have a GIS right now in fisheries, unfortunately. Building on that now, the USA did a lot of work in terms of hazard maps and so forth, mainly land-based, but there were a lot of coastal areas that were mapped as well, for example, for landslides. And as you know, this can affect a lot of the coastal areas, especially in the marine reserve here in the south. And then in 2010, the Fisheries Division collaborated with the Environmental Coordinating Unit on the Sustainable Land Management Project, where we did a lot of coastal mapping in different communities on the island and looked at areas that were vulnerable to flooding and sea level rise and so forth. Lots of training during that time as well. As you can see, a lot of other programs happening, mainly terrestrial as usual, not so much on the marine side. But the Fisheries Division has not lost the need or the competency to deal with or capture geospatial data. As a matter of fact, we've been continually collecting that. For example, fishing activities. We always ask the fishermen, where did you catch your fish and so forth. So this is critical for us in terms of knowing where some of the fishing areas are. Partly because a lot of our fishing is pelagic based, which is the fish moves all around, you know, it doesn't stay in one location. Also, we are moving a lot into FADs, fish aggregating devices. And a lot of programs have actually done a lot of work in terms of identifying the dynamics of FADs and how they work and other things. For example, we have Sea Grant, Magalisa, which is the French, and Texas A&M. We've also been doing a lot of exploratory fishing for species such as diamondback squid. A lot of that is going back to the fishermen as areas where they can find that resource and actually make use out of it. Diamondback squid, as a matter of fact, is a very high-end product. It's not very readily eaten in Dominica as we are not used to it, but it's something we're trying to promote right now. Another major area is in terms of reef monitoring and coastal resource activities. The coast was primarily used by fishermen, but because over the years, a lot of other people have found use for the marine area. A lot of user conflict has arisen and so forth, and we're trying to do that by actually mapping areas of activities. Ghost fishing is another area close to our heart with regards to fish spots, which are the fish traps being lost and fish still being caught in these things. So we try to tell the fishermen where they can and cannot place some of these devices. But we need, of course, some marine data for that. A number of companies, national companies, and as you line, have established geospatial capability, but the thing is, most of them don't actually share that data back with us. It's a challenge getting them to share it back with us. But we're going to talk to them on that. One recent initiative, though, is the Domino project, which is managed by the Physical Planning Division. I think some of you heard of me speak about that last year when you were here in December. This is a World Bank project, and also with the government of Dominica, and they began in 2012, doing some consultations with different stakeholders. Should I press OK? I should just stop here, or should I finish? Alright. I'm almost done. I'm almost done, yeah. So they also did a thing similar to what we did under the CRIS, Coastal Resource Information System, and whereby they're compiling data from different departments. Unfortunately, Fisheries Division was not invited to this. So what I've done is actually spoken to the person in charge of running this right now and gotten them to see that Fisheries Division was left out, unfortunately, to their detriment and ours. And trying to see how we can get Fisheries Division into this so we can have some marine data sets into this. As you can see, they have about 42 data sets, data layers presently available. They have a database, metadata, and data can be freely downloaded from the website, which is here, domino.net. You can always go and check it out. And I can create maps and other things like that. All right, thanks for listening.